Well, U.S. Secretary of State John Kerry paid an unannounced visit to Cairo today, but he didn't stick around long. He met a couple of VIPs, delivered a message, and got right back on the plane. It's an awkward time in relations between the United States and Egypt. Tomorrow, the former elected president, Mohamed Morsi, will go on trial for inciting violence and murder. CBC's Middle East correspondent Sasha Petrasik has more on Kerry's message.
The message was that the United States still wants to have a solid relationship with what has been one of the United States' most reliable allies in the Middle East, at least in the Arab side of the Middle East. As you say, it comes at an awkward time, not only because of this trial, which is supposed to begin tomorrow, but also because the United States, the opinion of the United States among Egyptians is probably at an all-time high. And the problems that most Egyptians have with the United States is probably the worst that it's been in quite a long time. That's why this visit was unannounced. That's why it came as a surprise. Kerry basically snuck into Cairo. They were trying to avoid the kind of protests and perhaps even violence that they expected to happen if people knew that he was coming. So he came. He came for a few hours. He met with the main leaders to deliver the message that President Obama wants to continue a solid relationship with Egypt, that it wants to help in whatever way it can to develop democracy here, that it doesn't like the violence that there's been, but Kerry didn't put too fine a point on that. He didn't, in fact, blame anybody for it. He certainly didn't blame the current ruling military government. And he was really, really trying to downplay some of the stronger statements that have come from the United States, including the holding back of millions of dollars in aid, which the U.S. announced just a few weeks ago. He said that's a temporary measure that was required under U.S. law, and he almost apologized for it, saying that it was going to change. This is the sort of thing that, this is the kind of message that he delivered. I guess for most Egyptians, it came as a surprise, and it also set the backdrop, I guess, for this trial, which is supposed to begin tomorrow. The first elected president of Egypt, Mohamed Morsi, who, if you might recall, last July was deposed by the military. The military installed its own leader and is now putting Mohamed Morsi on trial after holding him really since July incommunicado almost in a secret location with very limited access to his own family and even to lawyers.